wish you all a very happy Republic Day. We all gathered here to celebrate 68th Republic Day. I pray to God for the development and prosperity of the nation. Firstly, I welcome all the dignitaries, faculty, staff and students for this Republic Day occasion. A warm and heartfelt welcome to you all. It's a tradition and custom to start up our occasion with seeking the blessings of Almighty. Let's stand up for Tamil Thai Valku. Now I request our Honorable Chief Guest, Sekunda Rangarajan Ma'am, dignitaries and our beloved student, topper of this year, Mr. Neelakanta Panigrahi, to hoist the national flag.
Very good morning to all of you. I welcome you for the Republic Day function. And it is a great honor to me that today our President message, our President message is being delivered by our Chancellor, Dr. Sakuntala Rangaraja. Madam, I request you to deliver the message of Honorable President, Honorable Chancellor, Colonel Dr. V.R. Rangaraja. Madam.
Vice Chancellor, Minister, Directors and Deans, Heads, Faculty, Staff and Students, and the active participants in the Republic Day Parade, ladies and gentlemen, on this most important national day, let me first, as the founder, President and Chancellor, and the present President of Greater Dhaka and SR University, convey my whole heart greetings to you all on this 68th Republic Day of India. It is a matter of pride, joy, victory, satisfaction and emotion twinned with enhanced responsibility and commitment to rise and go down to the national flag and to the nation on this auspicious 26th January. On behalf of our composite and united family of Vedic fraternity, I stand before you with a humble request to all of you that we all need to rededicate ourselves to the national development to face the increasing global competence. Is it yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no, please tell. Yes, no we, no we.
Yes.
Thank you very much, thank you. In recent times, with the advent of globalization and enhanced economic development, there has been a significant spurt in the use of science and technology in day-to-day life as a national phenomenon. It is in this context there has always been a conflict between traditional and science. Despite of a great deal of complexity, India stands unique in the world in blending science and the traditional by supplementing each other. It is the time that we cannot afford to ignore the great sacrifice made by our great freedom fighter and ancestors, without which we would not have this opportunity of enjoying all freedom in every walk of life and scope of demonstration our intelligent caliber, rich tradition and culture, and all the more the innate human attitude. As time is lapsing, the country is witnessing more and more development in every sphere, including science and technology. But at the same time, competition from all over the globe has been deeply impairing on the development, making imperative the need for faster and higher rates of development to face the competition. It is at this stage the whole country looks at the young generation as its future hope. Is it correct? Young generation? You are all supporting?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. It is for you to stand and excel in science, technology and engineering and demonstration to the rest of the world that you can lead not only this country but also can make India the global leader. The development in space technology that this country has been witnessing and demonstrating to the rest of the world is unprecedented. We are all going to witness the world marvel in the field of space science when our nation is going to successfully launch 103 satellites in one go. Even science fiction would not perhaps have stretched its imagination to this extent. All this credit obviously goes to you. The young mind with the bubbling innovation, imagination and more ambition to achieve could accomplish this. I wish that the same temperament should be adopted by you in both personal and professional endeavors. Yes? Yes, yes?
Yes, ma'am.
It is time that the young talent should focus more on innovation that can address the future development which can be far beyond one's imagination. Science, technology and engineering fortunately have been growing hand in hand. However, more of synergy and comprehension between these three areas will empower you to compete with the best of the world. I reiterate and promise you on this pious day and that WearTech management and its dedicated staff will provide the best environment and opportunity and encouragement for you to unfurl of your boundless imagination. Yes? Honorably, Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji is unstinting commitment and unparalleled mission to eradicate corruption and provide fair and transparent mechanism for the public needs your committed involvement and support. As young technocrats, we have a great role to play in the concept of digital India, digital economy, and seamless and transparent administration. You can translate your innovative perception into practice in the field of digital economy, keeping in view the human psychology, the social status, national, regional, and the local economic structure and practice, and more so the need and the requirement to combat the unwanted interest of different segments of the society. The great strength of the nation are your clean and fair attitude, the unbounded intellectual capacities, the strength to synthesize and comprehend various technology strides and your commitment to achieve. It is in this context I sincerely suggest that you should work to achieve a goal without looking for financial and personal gains. Yes or no? Our achievement in science and technology would obviously pay a very strong and smooth way not only for your career growth but for the national development. Yes? As far as the innovation is concerned, I always wonder to recalculate and try to understand inherent wisdom and scientific basis of our exceptional traditions and practices, and I have always realized that very little is known to any one of us. It is time for you to provide into the hidden principles of our culture and practice and bring out the basic principles of science, controlling them and adapt them to your modern thoughts and innovation approaches which could produce the best in the world. The concept of Swachh Bharat, Digital India, Make in India, though of the innovative perception of our Honorable Prime Minister, you are the one and only one who can realize them as a national perception. Sovereign integrity and prospects of our nation are our top priorities. Let every one of us be dedicated ourselves to make India self-sustained and emerges as a global leader. Let us all continue to be one family and one nation, and on the eve of 68th Republic Day, I wish you all a wonderful career. Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you, ma'am, for your patriotic words that you just instruments to display the unity. Follow
4-5 Cadet Under Officer K. Hariharan, leading Air Wing NCC Contingent. Cadet Senior Under Officer B. Jayalakshmi, leading Army Wing NCC Contingent.
Result of this, they bag prizes for following. Best of R. Satish Kumar, he got selected and participated in RDC Parade at New Delhi 2016. Appreciation of this, management awarding Best Cadet Award.
Next to you,
the next prize goes to NSS Unit 1 Girls. The next prize goes. The next prize goes to Unit 2 Girls, NSS, Kavya and Jaghari. CPC Girls, Eshi Malika and Sahithi. Please give their appreciations by your applause. The next CPC boys, Dheeresh and Elisha Paul. Followed by Dance Club, Shivapriya. Dance Club boys, Rafar.
Hey, run, run.
The next, Arts and Drama Club, Ashman, third year CSE. Dance Club Shiva Priya for girls. Music Club Abdul Rafi Dekula. Charita.
Back.
Cricket team winner. He bagged, he's a team captain and even bagged the fourth prize in South Zone Kabaddi tournament. Next we call upon Warden Team Pentanath.
Madam. Ready? Captain. Done, ma'am.
Dear sir, all the HODs, staff, dignitaries, and for taking part in this occasion. A sincere thanks to each of the citizens present here and making this occasion successful. Once again, let's pay our tribute to our flag this day. Thank you, one and all. Jai Bharat Mahan, Jai Hind.
Too much, sir. I'm going to try it.